morning, Unity North. How about a hand
for the great music? Love train. There is a love train in this room right now, right? Oh, I'm trying to contain your excitement. Can you feel that there is love present in this room and you are part of it? There we go. There's so many good things happening today, and we want you to know that whoever you are and wherever you may be on your spiritual path, you are welcome on this love train. Those of you online, we're so glad that you're tuning in. Those in the room, we behold you as the magnificent light of the world that you are. And speaking of light of the world, there's a new chapter. There's all kinds of good things going on at Unity North. But Mary Patton is a student at the Unity Urban School up in Detroit, Michigan. And she happens to live, not in our backyard, but a good hour and a half away. But she says, I have to do an internship. And I want to do my internship on the love train that is Unity North Atlanta. Let's see if after working with me for 9 months, she may change her mind. We'll see. But we are so delighted. I asked her to just kind of get us started today with an opening prayer. You're going to be seeing a lot of her. She's going to be on the platform. She's going to be teaching a class. She's going to be around. Will you please welcome Mary Patton? And I asked Mary to just start off nice and easy. We'll take it easy on her the first week, to just open us up in prayer. You got to hold that mic close. This is the first lesson in ministerial school.
Hello, everyone. I am so excited to be here. I feel like a kid in a candy store with all the groups and teams that you have. I don't know which one to pick. I'm going to try to pick them all if I can. So let us pray. And as we relax and turn within, we release any outer concerns. If you need to, take a deep breath. Hold it a few seconds and slowly breathe out. We breathe in the love and peace of God. We are basking in the Christ presence right here and right now. And as we worship and learn and share together in this service, we take forth the gems that the Holy Spirit has for each of us. We are blessed in this moment. We are fully present. And we go forth this day knowing that we have shared, we have loved, and we have worshiped together. And for these and all blessings, we pray. Thank you, God. Amen.
So once again, will you just please welcome the newest member of the ministerial team, Mary Patton. All right, it's your chance to make a little bit of noise. Those of you online as well, we're going to get started. If you're able, up on your feet. We're walking each other home, yes, on a path of love and joy and peace and all that is good and holy, yes. Then I'm going to invite you to sing like you've never sung before. Let's kick it in, guys. It's a hand clapper. All right, let's hear it.
We walk the path of love. A path of grace. We walk the path of service and a path of faith. We walk the path of spirit, the path of Mother Earth. We walk the path of peace now and a path of rebirth.
Let's kick it up a little bit now.
As we walk all these paths, walking home, everyone is walking home, everyone is walking home, everyone is walking home, everyone is walking home.
Turn to your left, to your right with a handshake or a hug and say, welcome home to the people around you. Those of you online, welcome home. We're so grateful that you're tuning in and we're walking together, wherever you happen to be, wherever that might be, across the country, in a different country. We belong to each other, and we behold the light in you as you behold the light in our community. And we're so grateful that you are here this morning. Come on, there's somebody you don't know. Walk across and say, welcome home. All right, let's come on back now. And let's start this from the beginning. Get those hands going. Get your body involved in the exercise. Here we go.
We walk the path of love and a path of grace.
Amazing this morning.
Good morning, Unity North. I love this energy. You see, it's getting a little dark outside, but it is bright in this place. So thank you for that love and that energy, the sunshine that you bring. So if you are new to Unity North and this is your first Sunday and you're wondering, is it just the song? Is it August? No, it is Unity North. And you are welcome and you are home. We want to welcome you. We want to share that with you. We want to stay connected with you. So we have our welcome team coming up with welcome packets for you. And in that welcome packet is a Let's Connect card. And you can fill it out old school with a pen and paper. You can fill it out new school by scanning the QR code. But whatever way you choose, we hope that you do fill it out so you can get to know more about this amazing community. Because that way, when you get home, we can be there waiting for you and knowing your every move for the rest of the week because we're connected. Or you can just find out what the next couple events are at Unity North. Your choice. It's your choice. So if you can raise your hand nice and high so that we can share some love with you and keep them up till you get a welcome packet, this is your time. Thank you. If it's your first time, raise your hand and we'll get a welcome packet to you. Thank you so much for joining us. You can feel the sunshine a little bit different today. And that is you.
At Unity North, we believe that there are many paths to the one God, and we're so grateful that your path has crossed our path, whether online or in the room. And so we like to greet. We're going to maybe start something new. The word namaste. Everyone say that with me. Namaste.
Namaste.
The good in me beholds the good in you. That's it. So we're going to sing to all those who are here for the first time and to everybody in the room. Namaste. Namaste. The good in me beholds the good in thee. Together,
namaste, namaste. My heart sings, namaste.
Spread it around.
The good in me beholds the good in thee. Namaste, namaste, namaste.
Let's take that energy and spread it around the earth. Together, can we sing?
Namaste, namaste. My heart sings, namaste. The good in me beholds the good in thee. Namaste, namaste, namaste.
Namaste, the good in us beholds the good in everybody.
Thank you. And in the spirit of namaste, we want to say a special thank you to our prayer chaplains that are on duty this morning, Sarah, Marie, Juanita, and Mary. They are seated around the room, holding us all in sacred space, in a sacred energy. Whether we're in the room or online, we are being thought about, held, and loved. Thank you. And now, speaking of love, we shift to a special time in our service, which is announcement time. I love it. I love it. All right. So keep that energy, because our first announcement is about what's happening today. It's a special meeting, a special congregational meeting happening today at 1:30. So stay after service, get a light lunch. We got you covered. And we've got a town hall meeting. So that should be on your calendars. Make sure it's in your brain. We'll see you at 1:30. Our next exciting announcement is about Songfest. Yes, yes. Put your hands together for that. It's all right. You see on that beautiful slide an amazing picture of our own Natalie Goodwin, Will Hodge. We've got some amazing guests, Cindy Craven and Tom Wolfe. We know Tom Wolfe and his amazing harmonica playing, right? He just jumps on any instrument and just rocks it. So make sure, August 18th, 7:30, tickets have been available online. So we should be buying those tickets and selling out. It's going to be an amazing night. Also coming up is Unity Basics. Now, for a couple of months, I've been saying, you can come in your jammies. You can still come in your jammies. But just know it's a little bit different. But this is a great opportunity, an opportunity to take that next step into membership, an opportunity to learn more about Unity, an opportunity for fellowships with the amazing people that are in the room right now. So that's at the end of the month, August 26th and 28th, Unity Basics. And then as our singer for this morning starts to come up, our last announcement is about spiritual connections. And so that is coming up starting September 20th. And we know how time goes. It feels like, oh, that's so long from now. It's really not. It's going to fly by. So if you are interested in being a facilitator for spiritual connections, this is that opportunity to make that known. So spiritual connections happens on Wednesday, either before that lovely Wednesday dinner, that catered dinner that's back, or right after Wrapping with the Rev. But they happen on Wednesday, so check on the app or go on to unitynorth.org if you are interested in being a facilitator. But right now, let me tell you about the amazing voice of Miss Sandy Blair. If you do not know Miss Sandy, she is about to rock the house. That's the only way that I can put it. She has an outstanding amount of energy. Ooh, I just can't believe. Just put your hands together. Get your souls ready for Sandy Blair.
Thank you so much. This song is about understanding what possessions, how they can hang us up. I love this. It's one of my favorite songs for you. About the life I've lived, a figure made of clay, and think about the things I've lost, the things I gave away. And when I'm in a certain mood, I search the halls and look. One night I found these magic words in a magic book. Throw it away, throw it away. Give your love, live your life each and every day. And keep your hand wide open, let the sun shine. Never lose a thing if it belongs to you. There's a hand to rock the cradle and a hand to help us stand. With a gentle kind of motion as it moves across the land, and the hands unclenched and open, gifts of light and love it brings. So keep your hand wide open if you need anything. Never lose a thing if it belongs to you. Natural obligation for what we own and claim, possess in and belong into, acknowledging a name. So keep your hand wide open if you need love today, 'cause you can't lose it even if you throw it all away. Belongs to you. You can never lose a thing if it belongs to you. You can never lose a thing if it belongs to you. Thank you.
Good night, Atlanta. Thanks for coming. Woo! Don't share the platform with kids, with animals, and Sandy Blair, because we're done. Just drop the mic and let's get out of here. You know, I really, not only is her talent evident and her soul evident, but you know, I, as a minister, I come up with these titles. And I give them titles, and they go, what the heck do I do with this? And I know for a fact she was wrestling. She talked to Danielle this week. I said, where is he going with this? And then she kicked it right back at me, and she sent two songs my way. And I went, what do I do with this? So there's a co-creative process happening here, and I want to just, before he gets out of the room, if he's leaving, how about Brian Reed on the piano as well? So Sandy has thrown down the gauntlet to throw it away, let it go, let it go. Open up your hands, open up your hearts, open up your spirit, open up your mind to receive. Everything you believed about yourself to be true, can you set it down for a moment? Leave it at the door if you want it, the good, the bad, and the maybe the stinking thinking. You can leave it at the door. It'll be there if you want it when you leave. But maybe we can do a great cleansing and throw it all away and start anew, to be reborn again, to be born again in mind and heart and spirit, and to recognize that we are pretty wonderful people. Yes? I don't know if I believe you yet. Give me a sermon. By the way, if I convince you in 20 minutes, we'll stop. But if it takes an hour, I'll give you an hour. We are starting a brand new series today. And how many people enjoyed the Freedom series we did last month? I saw a hand go up over here that went, Not too sure, but it's all about relationships for the month of August. How many people have relationships? You in the balcony? I'm sorry. We all have relationships. It's a subject that's vitally important to this earth school. Do we realize that we're in school? You're on earth. You're walking the earth. You incarnated at this time in this place with a whole bunch of teachers. Look around. These are your teachers. Think of the people at work, the people in your family. They are your teachers. That is the curriculum. And so we're going to spend a lot of time talking about that curriculum for the month of August. We're going to start light, maybe not so light, and then we're going to go for a deep dive. Are we good for the deep dive? Yeah. That means you got to come back. Yep. Only four weeks. Relationships are the curriculum and the teachers. You want to learn about yourself? Who comes here to learn about themselves? Study your relationships. Uh-oh, he's starting to meddle, Joel. Here he goes again. You want to grow emotionally? You want to grow mentally? You want to grow spiritually? Study your relationships. You know, I look at the life that I live today and the good that I get to experience today, and I've been in some wonderful classes, wonderful services in churches, in school, but none of it compares to the education I got being in relationship with the people in my life. You can come here, this is good, but unless you take the principles and the ideas that we espouse from this platform and apply them in your relationships and allow them to be applied back at you from somebody who challenges you, from somebody who calls you out, well, it's just a divine idea and nothing ever happens. There is no growth mentally, emotionally, or spiritually. Who wants to find God? By whatever definition. I know the word God is tough for somebody. Maybe in this relationship we can get past a word. It's just a word. We're looking for that infinite spirit of life and love, that divine idea of the allness of creation. We all want a deep relationship with that. Well, then take a look at the people you have incarnated with on earth. It is not an accident. The people you're sitting next to right now, it's not an accident. It's a divine appointment. Everybody in your family, everybody in your work, it's a divine appointment. Make it rain. Did you see that it started to rain? Make it rain. Let love rain down as we study relationships, the good and the not so good, because it's all in a manifestation of the God energy, yes? So let's walk through what we're going to talk about for the month of August. Let's go ahead and put the talk titles up on the screen. Week number one, and that is today, we'll start light. Listeners, lovers, and lighthouses. Say the phrase with me on the second part of that. I want to. How many people have those shiny people that you just love? They show up on the planet and they look so good. I want to be them. Number two, week two, the mystics, the misfits, and the mavericks. Together, I want to be like myself. Okay, number three. Now we start to take a little bit of a deeper dive in week three. Nuisances, narcissists, and negativity. Anybody know those people? No, I haven't met them. They're everywhere. They're everywhere. Together, I don't want to be like... Freudian slip! I don't want to be like them. And then week four, we bring it all together with a big bow on top of it. Oneness, optimists, and open-minded. And together we say, I am them. Throughout the journey, there's going to be an I am them through the whole process. I invite you to keep your hands, your mind, your heart, your spirit wide open. A mantra that I have often shared from this platform, and you've heard it many times from me. Let's go ahead and put that slide up there and let's say it together. It is a mission statement for me and one that contextualizes my ministry. Together, shine your light so brightly that others cannot help but know that same light exists in them. I get up in the morning and I say that mantra. No matter how tired I am, no matter how difficult the day might be, no matter how great it might be, it's the same mantra. Let me shine in the midst of what is mine, what is before me, my life, my experiences, that the people I interact with can also know that that same light exists in them. For this series, we're going to flip it upside down. We're going to turn it all upside down and look at it with different eyes and different lenses. Time reflecting on the people in our lives who seem to have a little bit extra. You know who they are? The people in your life that seem to be, I call them shiny, happy people. They seem to have something on the ball. They seem to have that magical little energy around them. The shiny, bright people that appear to have the ears of the Christ. We talk about it, but they have the ears. They are the listeners of the Christ. The heart of the Buddha, those people that can find love and be love even in the midst of the most difficult situations. I want to be like them. Or the people that appear to have the light of 1,000 Mother Teresa's that stir a light in our own heart. We see them and they stir something within us and we do something different or we don't. It either stirs or it doesn't, depending on how we respond to the lighthouses, the lovers, and the listeners when they show up. Because your life is your life. Your choice is your choice, right? Life is consciousness. And you can want and desire the consciousness of the lighthouse all you want, but unless you do something different, it's their lighthouse and not yours. Amen. That's a hard lesson. Let's see if we can dig a little deeper and meddle just a little further. So these extra special people, these otherworldly beings, sometimes they resemble aliens. Now, where'd they come from? What planet are you from? They seem to have something I don't. I want to be like them. Or as that famous line from When Harry Met Sally, you all know it. I'll have what she's having. I look at the people in here, and I look at Drea, firewalker over there, and I go, I'll have what she's having. Shiny, happy lighthouse, or Marianne. There's more light in your household than anywhere I've ever been. But the reality is I want to be like them. I want to know what it is that makes them tick, that makes them so full of life. Many of those people hang around here at Unity North. Look around. Think about them. I want you to take a moment, and I want you to close your eyes. Think about those shiny, happy lighthouses, those lovers, those listeners, those people that make the world a better place. Just hold them close. Bring them into the environment. And the first thing I want you to do is to say thank you. Let thank you and gratitude be in your heart. You know, I'm convinced that this world just needs a little bit more thank you. I notice. I see you. I behold you. And we don't take the time. Over the last year, I've done too many memorial services where people regretted they didn't say thank you. Let that thank you be beyond space and time and speak it in your heart right now. And then I want you to bring those lighthouses into this energy right now. And on the count of three, I want you to call their name into the environment. To not just call it out, but to yell it out. To let the energy of these people that impacted your life in such a positive way, whether they're still living or not, whether they're in the room or not, call their name out. 1, 2, 3. I don't feel the fullness yet. Call their name out as if it's a passionate expression of the commitment that you have to recognize their light. 1, 2, 3. We're getting there. I heard Harry. I miss Harry Cohn. Harry Cohn, I heard his name at 2 or 3 places. Maybe it's a different Harry, but I'm just wild about Harry. Close your eyes again. Now I want you to make an inventory. What is the list of that person? What is Harry? Or whatever name you called. What are the divine ideas? What are the energies that they brought to your life, to this planet, that you so recognize? Live in them, steep in them, breathe them, know them, claim them, and then narrow it down to one. Just pick the one thing that this lighthouse brought to the world that you recognize. On the count of three, call that energy into this space and into this room. You see, the spoken word is bringing energy onto earth. It's important that we just don't think it, but that we think it and then we speak it. On the count of three, speak that quality, that number one quality that impacted your life. 1, 2, 3. Good, I'm not feeling the fullness yet. 1, 2, 3. One more time. 1, 2, 3. All right. You know, I teach in this community, and Unity teaches that you cannot help but be the prayer for somebody else. The knower, the gratitude energy for somebody else and not have that same energy live in you at a greater degree. So as we spoke it out, you not only blessed the person, wherever they might be, but you blessed yourself.
And by being a blessing in your own skin, in your own life, in your own language, in your own thought, you were a blessing to the people in this room. Let it integrate. Let it integrate. And to take these lighthouses, these listeners and lovers, and make them you. Because there is only one of us here, right? There's only one of us here. There's only one of us throughout history, throughout time, those that have been, those that are here, those that are elsewhere, those that will come that we haven't even met yet. Think about the great masters. Call out the great masters of time. Let me hear them. Jesus is one of them. Who else? Buddha. Lao Tzu. Even Charles Fillmore made the list today. And he does make the list. Charles and Myrtle. We don't want to forget the great woman behind the man. He gets all the credit, but she deserves all the credit because she was the consciousness. I'm living like Drea Firewalker now. But the reality is Jesus, Krishna, Buddha, Lao Tzu, even Charles and Myrtle Fillmore and the names that you mentioned, people flocked to them. You ever notice that? That people wanted to be in their essence. They came from miles and miles around just to touch the hem of the garment. Just to touch the hem of the consciousness, to stand at the edge of their heart and experience that energy. It's a natural byproduct of lighthouses. They are bringing the boats in. They don't have to go seeking anything or anybody. They just radiate at the level of who they are, and people clamor to be there. They were all saying at one level or another as they made the pilgrimage to get there, I'll have what he's having. I'll have what she's having. And that feels really good. We all have those people. I want what they're having. But what many of us fail to recognize in those great masters, as well as the names that you mentioned here today, we forget to witness these people, and that's the backstory. Everybody's got a backstory. The history and the footsteps that they all walked to get to that place of listening, to get to that place of loving, and that shiny place of being a lighthouse. Let me clearly state, shininess does not happen by accident. Say that with me. Shininess doesn't happen by accident. Yours, theirs, mine, anybody's. Shininess doesn't happen by accident. And so many of us on the planet are so into just reading the last chapter. We don't want to go through the drudgery of the first three to set up the plot, to set up the characters, to get a relationship with those characters. Let me just skip chapter 1 through 15 and get to the end of the book and cut to the chase. Anybody do that? Not in this church. Other churches do that. But the reality is that our environment and our country is set up to want the magic pill at the end. I want the lighthouse experience on the end. I want the love and I want the listening on the other side, but we're not willing to read the first 15 chapters. You've got to read the first 15 chapters or it doesn't stick. Yes? There's work behind it. Throughout this series, I am going to refer to the old standard, new thought teaching. It's a little bit worn out, but it bears repeating again and again and again. We are all mirrors for each other. Say that. We are all mirrors for each other. Sometimes indicated with this phrase, and I'm going to ask you to say a number of times together, if you spot it, you've got it. Put your hand on your heart and say it again, if you spot it, you got it. Many of us easily adopt that idea on the surface, and a lot of New Thought people are living at the surface, and they're okay with that, but they rarely look at the work, the effort, the study, and the practice it took for these shiny people to get shiny. There's a lot of elbow grease, as my grandfather would put it, spit polish, a lot of effort and energy. Oh, I don't want to spot that. I don't want to look at that. I don't have the capacity to work that hard. And so we skip the first 15 chapters and cut to the chase, saying things like, I don't have the time. I don't have the energy. I don't have the money. But let me tell you, Jesus, Lao Tzu, Buddha, they didn't have the money either. But somehow they managed to get shiny without that limitation. I'm saying on the spiritual path, we need to quit focusing on what we don't have and focus on what we do have. But what I would say, what you don't have, is you're not getting there, is you don't have a priority. Uh-oh, I'm meddling, Joel. I don't have a priority. I see it, I spot it, I want it. Nah, I'm going to go take a nap instead. Hard work. The spiritual path of evolution is a hard path that requires work. You do have the time.
because if you spot it, you got it. You have within you the capacity to manifest anything in your life. It's been given to you. Keep your hands wide open. Keep your heart wide open, because your limited thinking cannot maybe see it, but if you spotted it and you spotted the effort and the time and the energy and the money it took to get there, it's at your disposal. But we close our hands and God says, right here, stand at the door and knock. I'm trying to give it to you, but your hands are closed. Your heart is closed and you're living in a limited world. So you will never become a lighthouse at the brightest level. We have to keep our mind and our hearts wide open. Many people in New Thought want the lighthouse experience, but we're not willing to assemble the lighthouse brick by brick. Chop wood, carry water, as they say. Let's read this together. Many in New Thought want the lighthouse experience, but aren't willing to assemble the lighthouse brick by brick by brick by brick. And you know what happens when you're not willing to put that effort in? You will eventually attract different people to you. Different mirrors will show up. So you've attracted the shiny, happy people willing to put the effort in. But if you're not willing to put the effort in, they will move away. And you're going to attract different mirrors. And those mirrors are going to be, we'll talk about in week 3. But we're going to have judgment about those mirrors. Oh, those people are going to show up. You create the space by not jumping in, by not doing the work and putting in the effort, and different mirrors will find their way to you. But we'll talk about those people in week 3. None of them in any of these weeks is there by accident. It's a divine appointment. You manifested it. As a creative being in the image and after the likeness of creativity itself, they're there for a reason. And they're here, every one of them, to help us ask the question, is my spiritual path a way of life? Or is it a hobby? Oh, man. No, I'm getting to the soft part. Don't worry. Is my spiritual path a way of life, or is it a hobby? A good question to ask, not with blame and shame. Just go, am I in it? Am I in it to win it? Or am I in it sort of put my toe in the water? Every person you meet, every person you've ever met, the good, the bad, and the ugly, is there to show up at the perfect time in our lives to reflect something we need to acknowledge in ourselves. Sometimes it's the good, just asking for expression. I stand at the door and knock, let me out. It's the door inside that says, let me out. That good is there to say, you've got it. There's more of you to offer the planet. You're an amazing, beautiful, holy, sacred being of light. And these people showed up because your vibration was at that level. And when you step back, you invite in the other mirrors. I don't have the time, the energy, the talent, or the priority. The people with whom we interact are showing us who we are and ultimately providing us with an opportunity to love ourselves. That's it, to love ourselves. Say that with a hand on a heart, I love myself. I love myself. That's a good theory. But do you really love yourself? Let's explore that. This idea of a mirror is often used only when it comes to shadow work. Don't we love our shadow work? Oh, let's dig in and talk about my flaws and my mistakes and my difficulties and my darknesses. We will get there. Today, I'm inviting you to just sit for a moment and recognizing that you are valuable, that you are worthy of love. And you, many people in this room love everybody else at a high level and love yourself at a very low level. What I'm talking about is a mirror is just an opportunity to expose where you have not loved yourself at the fullest of what you are meant to be. I know that Dre and Marianne love themselves, and they don't make apology for that. I want to live in your household. I want what you have. But the reality is we're going to get to that place of negativity. That's going to be in week 3, and I hope you will come and make a commitment. We will do shadow work. But cut yourself some slack and reflect with a positive spin. I notice this great good. I see Bill Ernst and Sue Ernst, and you make a difference on this planet. And I love and value the way you show up, the wisdom that you bring to the planet. I notice it. That means it's calling for me to do the same. Oh, the desirable behaviors that we see in others are also a reflection of ourselves, but in order, and I want you to hear this online and in the room, in order to integrate this observable good, it's one thing to notice it. We need a foundation of self-love. Let's read this statement together. In order to integrate this observable good, we need to have a foundation of self-love, or it doesn't make it past the gatekeeper of our self-judgment. This is not a theory for me. This is 50 years of my life. The judgment that I held about myself, less than, greater than as well, both manifestations of ego. It blocked a whole bunch of good getting into it. Oh, I could notice that. I was, thank you. Thank you, Avril, for being such a light in my life. But my self-judgment, I can't be Avril. I can't be as smart or as articulate as she is. I never will be. Well, maybe I will if I work at it. And I put the work in that Avril put in. But the reality is the self-judgment blocked it. The self-judgment is a manifestation of ego, and it will keep me from growing. It will keep me from stretching. I don't love myself to know that if I spot it in Avril, I've got it too. Yes? Not so easy. And if self-love is not present, the manifestations cannot integrate and will manifest in other ways. So the self-judgment takes the lead in the bus. Self-love takes the backseat. What are the energies that show up when it comes to the shiny, happy people? Envy. Jealousy. I'm judgmental that it's not real. And I start to make comments like, well, Avril isn't that smart. You know, I've seen Dre and Marianne when they weren't happy with each other. And we begin to go, the little neener neener machine, the monkey mind begins to go crazy in your head, finding another excuse. Self-judgment is keeping the good that is there at bay. Things like self-judgment take the form of, it's not real. I know they have problems. Well, good. Maybe you're willing to study the backstory. They do have problems. I know the stories of everybody I've mentioned in here. Bill and Sue Ernst are sitting there. Their backstory is challenging, and it's challenging to this day. Yet they don't let the backstory define them. They remain shiny. They remain a lighthouse. They remain the lovers and the listeners. It cannot be integrated if you're living in those judgmental energies of yourself. You're looking for the chink in the armor. Mostly it's going to manifest a self-judgment. Avril's better than me. Ted's better than me. Mike, we're on the same field. The reality is, those are the words that the ego will speak, and it will come up because you don't love yourself enough to let the good in. And to realize if you spot it, you got it. Say it again. If you spot it, you've got it. Water will seek its own level. Vibration seeks its own level, yes? That's all we are, water and vibration. And we're seeking our own level. So if I'm vibrating at the level of self-love, I will be able to manifest in my life things that validate that love. If I'm operating and vibrating, the water is going to flow to self-judgment if that's what I'm holding. And so this journey about mirrors is all an opportunity to heal what needs to be healed. The thoughts of untruth that you have believed about yourself. Anybody else do that besides me? Who's ever believed an untruth about yourself? I see it, Drea, the backstory. Oh, let me spend some time in your essence so I can read chapter 1 through 6 to see how you got to be that person and how your household changed. If some degree of self-love isn't present, the good will vibrate away from you. Today I'm asking each of us on this month to make a commitment to love and accept some good about yourself that you have spotted in another. Not pridefully. Not arrogantly, but as Marianne Williams would tell you, how dare you play small? How dare you self-judge what I have given you as a manifestation of my very essence as Winifred White? How dare you hold any idea or thought that you were not the manifestation of God in form and take every step in that direction? The good that I asked you to reflect upon on that list, close your eyes again. Those qualities. What are those qualities you saw in that lighthouse? If you spot it, you've got it. Hold it, breathe it, and be grateful in this moment for yourself that that potentiality, that possibility lives in you. It's waiting for expression. It's standing at the door saying, I'm knocking. For God's sake, open up. And what I want you to do now with your eyes closed is to scream out like you did the first time. No, do it more. To yell out into this environment your name followed by that quality. On the count of three, your name and the quality that you admire, respect, and love in another. One, two, three. Let it in. Oh, I can't see that. I can't feel that. That feels inauthentic. It's not about fake it till you make it. It's about just know it and claim it and be it. Speak your name and that quality again. One, two, three. A little closer. Now let every cell of your being proclaim the truth about you. Not just your voice, but your mind, your heart, your spirit, all wide open to receive the magnificence that God has placed into your life, into your soul. On the count of three, one, two, three. That is a divine appointment. And let everything you say, everything you do, every relationship you have, every interaction you have, good, bad, and otherwise, be a reflection of what you just claimed as truth. And don't settle. Nobody speaks about my congregation and my congregants in a little way. I won't let you do it about yourself. We used to tell our foster kids that, and it was a great thing. They would say something horrible about themselves, and as parents would say, nobody talks about my kids like that. I'm not going to let you get away with it. And so, Imani, next time I hear you say something about yourself that is an untruth, I'm going to call you out on it. Because nobody talks about my friend. Nobody talks about my congregant that way. Why would I allow you to do it? Okay, do it one more time, your name and the truth. One, two, three. Good. Let's this week and this month work on integrating that. Anybody ever know those people who can quote the Bible? They know chapter and verse. They can go and tell you where everything is found in that Bible. They know it backwards and forwards, but all they are words. They're not integrated practices. I know those people. We can become like them when it comes to the vibration of the lovers in our life. And the listeners in our life are lighthouses. I can tell you 100 people that are really wonderful, but until I integrate that wonderfulness in my own self and claim it for myself, it's just a bunch of words. Every step must be integrated with the truth of who you are. Yes? They say the only Bible that some people will ever read will be your life. The only Bible some people are ever going to read is going to be your life. And many people are going to show up. Gospels are going to show up in your field. Mirrors, teachers, curriculums going to show up. Read the gospel of those lives, but don't just memorize scripture and verse. Don't just be grateful that you notice in them. Respect them enough. Honor them enough to say, I want to be like you. No, I will be like you. And I will do whatever it takes from chapter 1 to chapter 15 to be more of you. I want what you're having, Bill Coons. That's really honest. I really want what you're having. Consciousness attracts. Yes? Say that with me. Consciousness attracts. Consciousness magnetizes. Consciousness heals. Consciousness elevates. Holy books that show up as the people around you. The Holy Bible shows up in your field, but their good does not get absorbed into your life because you're running a false narrative. Nobody talks about my kids or my congregation that way. I am not worthy. I am not good enough. I'm not as good as. I can't. Yada, yada, together. Yada. There's a lot of yada yada going on in the spiritual new thought world. I don't want to hear any more yada yada yada. Here's my steps for the week and for the month I want you to take before we go into meditation. The band can come up. Let's go ahead and take a picture of the slide. I want you to integrate these into your life. These are practices I want you doing for the entire month of August. And you can take a picture or you can write them down. Number one, notice the shiny people. Have the eyes and the ears and the heart to recognize them. You need to be on alert. Develop a consciousness that is magnetizing those lighthouses and those lovers. Number two, then go surround yourself with those people. You become like the people you hang out with. Plain and simple. go hang out with them, seek them out, and put the effort in to spend time with the shiny people. Bill, what are you doing for lunch this week? Larry Staria, let's go have a chat, because I want a little bit of what you have. And be willing to say it with gratitude in your heart. Number three, interview them, study them. Study them. Not just chapter 16, but chapter 1 through 15. How did you get, Marianne, how did you get there? How did you get to be that person? Are you willing to vulnerably share your story? Gosh, and what we find out is that her story is my story. Different parts of the world, different ways of being on the planet, yet it's the same story. Let me interview her and then emulate it. Try their clothes on for size. Marianne, I'm not going to try your clothes on. Try their clothes and their shoes on for size and begin to work with the energies of the shiny people and the lighthouses. Number four, be mindful. Mindfulness is absolutely key to the spiritual path. Mindful of my language. Does my language symbolize lighthouse energy or self-judgment? Self-love or self-judgment? Notice your language, your reactions and your behaviors and your thoughts. And then the next step, hold yourself accountable. That's it. Hold yourself accountable. And then as a minister, it's part of my job. Nobody talks about my kids, my family, my congregation. Part of my job is to hold you accountable. Stinking thinking isn't going to get you to the dream. I'm a dream builder. I want your dream and I want the reality. So you might want to change that thought. You might want to look at that word, because it's not shiny. It's coming from self-judgment and not self-love. And then intentionally speak and react in a different way. React and speak and act and feel as a lighthouse. What does it feel like? I want to hear from you. What does it feel like to be a lighthouse person, a shiny person? What are those qualities? Call out.
Confidence.
Confidence. What else? Humor. Authenticity. Just a few moments ago, I asked you to say your name. And then a quality that you saw in another that you were claiming for yourself. Call it out one more time, because that's the answer to the question. What does it feel like to be a lighthouse? One, two, three. Feel like that. Even when you're tired. Even when you're down, your commitment says, yep, I've got within me. I spotted it. I've got it within me. I'm going to cultivate it and nurture it. A little music would be great. And then love yourself. Love yourself through failures. Through mistakes, through forgetting, knowing that the spotted if you got it energy doesn't change just because you screwed up, just because you fell down. You still got it within you. Don't lose sight of the light that is right there saying, I'm standing at the door and knocking, let me out. Yeah, you screwed up, so what? Pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and start all over again. And then I think that it's probably the hardest step is be consistent about that. The only way I can stand here today and do the job that I am supposed to do is because there were a bunch of lighthouses in my past that saw good in me I couldn't see for myself. Ministers who saw it in me, who said, nobody talks about my friend like that. I had to overcome so many obstacles to even be comfortable in my skin to stand here and to say these things and to challenge you. You want to know dark night of the soul and some shadow work that's been done? I'll tell you those. But I'll fill your heart and your soul with the shiny people who saw something in me that I could not see for myself. That's what we do here. Mike Stott is a lighthouse for me. Willis, you are a lighthouse for me. I miss playing pickleball with you, brother. Everybody else got better than me. But look around and gather the evidence. Surround yourself with these people and tell them, I love you. You've made a difference. One of the lighthouses that put me into this position, Reverend Michael Moran. He got real close to death this last month. He's making his peace and he's saying goodbye. And I realized I'd wasted a whole lot of time not telling him, I stand as a symbol of your love. I stand as a symbol of you being a lighthouse in my life. Why would I waste one more minute? Thank God he had a near-death experience, but he's really close. And we connected on the phone, and we've been texting each other, say, you matter, brother. You matter.
and you've made a difference. Be consistent about getting up after the dark night. Be consistent about recognizing those shiny people and tell them. And when you can love yourself enough to do it again and again and again and again, you are shining your light so brightly. You see, that mantra is not an accident for me. You begin to shine your light so brightly that others around you that you'll never meet are going to be saying, I want what he's having. I want what you're having. And somehow the water in the harbor raises all the boats. Be a lighthouse. Be a lover. Be a listener. Be a mirror. We're going to go into meditation with another song, Namaste. Look around the room. Just make eye contact with somebody. Pat Worrell doesn't even know how she has impacted my life. I get to spend time with Pat Worrell every Friday night over at Don's house. And people think, oh, it must be wonderful to go spend time with Don. It is. It must be wonderful to go spend time with Ted. Ted and I have known each other for a long time. And Judy Demmer. But if I were to pick, it's like the Wizard of Oz. I think you're my favorite. And I realize today as I sit here and look at Pat Worrell that she has no idea that I go to that lunch and that dinner because Pat Worrell is there. You matter to me. You mean something to me. You are a lighthouse. And I love you for that. And it's a place of namaste. If Pat's got it and I spot it, I've got it too. Let's sing this song together to go into meditation.
The good in me, behold the good in you. Namaste. The good in me, behold the good in you.
Look at you, Tony.
Namaste. Namaste.
Patterson. A time of meditation and take that good and let it be integrated. Avril?
As we did earlier, I invite you at this time to adjust your body and become comfortable and close your outer eyes. Be aware of the body, the ability to move the body, and that you're making a choice to hold the body in a place of effortlessness and stillness. Bring your attention into your breath. And maybe it's the first time that you are connecting with your breath all day long. Begin to take deeper, longer, more intentional breaths. As you inhale, inhaling peace and tranquility. And as you exhale, letting go of anything that does not serve you at this time. And again, as we did earlier, Visualize someone that you love or admire very easily. You're seeing this person in your mind's eye, and to the best of your ability, make this image crisp and clear. Remember an encounter. Remember their face. They may be alive, or maybe they've left the earthly realm. You cannot do this wrong. And as you're visualizing this person that you love, notice the experience that you feel in your own heart. And with your mind's eye, look into their eyes. See their Buddha nature, their Christ consciousness. Begin to see this love as light, and it may take on any color or form. It might be vivid or a little muddled. And from your heart, speak to their heart silently. Shine your light so brightly that others cannot help but know the same light exists in them. And again, just notice what comes up for you. What sensations? And as beautiful as that is, as wonderful as that feels, now we stretch ourselves. And this time, your heart pump is primed. So begin to visualize someone that you don't know very well. What we'll describe as a neutral person. Perhaps a person you shook hands with today, or even hugged. A cashier you see every week, a neighbor you know informally. In your mind's eye, to the best of the ability you have, visualize this person and look into their eyes. And as you did with your beloved, see their Buddha nature. See their Christ consciousness. And again, I invite you to feel this love as light. And it may take on any color or form, very bright or maybe more dim. And you say from your heart, again, silently to theirs, shine your light so brightly that others cannot help but know the same light exists in them. Notice your sensations. But of course, we have to stretch more, because this is all about growth. So we embrace the mirrors that reflect the harder lessons. And in this now moment, with your heart so wide open, in such a safe space, visualize someone you have a difficult relationship with. It can be something personal or more global or political. Lean into the sharp edge. This is God doing business as this person. Look into their eyes and see their Buddha nature, their Christ consciousness. Feel this love is light, even if they don't see it. It may be color, it may be white, vivid or dim. From your heart, speak directly into theirs and say, shine your light so brightly that others cannot help but know the same light exists in them. And now we take the fourth and final step, maybe the most difficult. And in your mind's eye, see your own self as a mirror, not a younger, not a more attractive or a more successful version. See yourself in the mirror right now. Look into your own eyes and see your Buddha nature, your Christ consciousness. Feel this love radiate from yourself as light, and it may take on any color or form, vivid or dim. And now speak into your own heart a great vow. I will shine my light so brightly that others cannot help but know the same light exists in them. Feel that resonant with every heart in this room and on the screens in this now moment, all radiant, connected heart to heart in a moment of silence as we remain in that space. Observe the silence that's one and the same as our Buddha nature, our Christ consciousness. Remain aware of that silence that expands from heart to heart as you reflect on the relative quietness of your mind at this time. Remain aware of that silence as you notice the smoothness of your breath. Bring back the silence as you open your eyes and look around and see it in everyone. Namaste.
Thank you, Avril.
Beautiful as always. There's a couple of lighthouses in this room that you never see them. And I was sitting there with the beautiful meditation. I was reflecting on four people that are sitting in this room every Sunday, but they're up in the back. And I was saying today that they're sometimes hidden back there. But I mentioned a lot of names today, and I would be remiss not to mention the four people that make sure that we can reach those people online, make sure that you can hear and turn me off when you don't want to hear. No. But I want to, there's lovers and listeners and lighthouses up in our booth, and that's Michael, Sebastian, Wes, and Sarah. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, Daniel.
As I was listening to meditation and all of the beautiful thoughts that were here present today, I was thinking of how Unity North gets to be a lighthouse, an opportunity for us to collect our individual lights and then shine them together in this beautiful community, this beautiful lighthouse, so that other communities and other people cannot help but know that they have that same light within them. And that thought just made me think of you all and how blessed we are. So as our ushers are coming forward, as we move into offering time, we recognize there are many ways to give. We can give physically in the baskets. We can scan the QR code, go in the app, go online. And if you filled out a Let's Connect card, which we hope you did, we promise not to track you. But if you put that in the basket, you can stay in the loop and know what is happening in this community that is full of light and energy. And our prayer box is also coming forward as well, a beautiful reminder, again, that we are held, that we are seen as whole, we are seen as the light that we are, as our prayer chaplains pray over that and are also available for prayer before and after service. So right now, let's bless our offerings in advance by saying our offering blessings together. I am so blessed. I am so prosperous, and it is my great pleasure to share of my blessings and to share of my prosperity. And in the giving, the entire world is blessed. Thank you, God. Please join us as we sing our song together.
I am so
earlier that I threw a challenge at Sandy Blair and she threw it back at me, and this is the song that she came out with, and I think it's absolutely perfect. It's called Monkey See, Monkey Do. And so please welcome once again Sandy Blair.
Thank you. Love has got us locked up, peaches. We're locked inside. Your bananas get thrown at me, might get thrown at you. Every night we fuss and fight like crazy humans do. I guess love is monkey see and monkey do. That's all it is, Peaches. Love is monkey see and monkey do. Would I lie to you? Love is monkey see and monkey do. That's all it is, Peaches. Love is monkey see and monkey do. Do, 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 do. You want my love, Peaches? Or do you want my rage? Or do you merely love to see me shake my cage? Your papayas get thrown at me, mine get thrown at you. I guess love is love is monkey see and monkey do. That's all it is, Peaches. Love is monkey see and monkey do. Would I lie? gonna jump and bump and eat this jungle until I get my fill. Then you'll know the truth, peaches, that one and one ain't two. One and one is one. And monkey see and monkey do. That's all it is, peaches. Love is monkey see and monkey do.
Beautiful, beautiful. Thank you, Sandy. Hey, monkey see, monkey do. Give me a little do 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 do. One, two, three, go. I want you to scat the whole week and the whole month of this series. Let's end with just being grateful for the love that we have been given today. Sandy, Danielle, Avril, the band, the guys in the booth. All of it's just been beautiful. Welcome, Mary Patton. There she is. Can you give us a closing prayer? I'm going to put her on the spot. Welcome to ministry. She's not in the order of service. Give us a final closing word or a prayer.
Well, my final.
Hold it close, though. That's number one.
I'm learning. I'm a student. Closing prayer is the light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. And wherever we are, God is, and all is well. And I want to say that my gem for this week will be beauty. And that was my word, Mary Beauty. So just
Mary Beauty. Claim it, say it, know it. All right, so go forth. I'm going to have them play that last song one more time. We're not going to do the closing song. We're just going to scat on the way out of here. So give me a do 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 do. Monkey see, monkey do. Don't be shy. Go up to somebody and give them a do 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 do. Thank you.